Thank you. Thank you. down quite. What did you do up there, Alex?
Well, you know me, I asked her for a kiss.
A kiss? What did she say?
Well, she said she'd give me a kiss, as long as the top was down, so we could kiss under the stars.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyway, 2 hours later,
Wait. Did you just say 2 hours later?
Yeah.
It only takes me 15 seconds to get my top down. Well, what's wrong with you?
Well, yeah, but you have a convertible.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have an important announcement. Rock and roll is here to stay!
Why, this car is automatic. It's synchronized. It's hydromatic. What do you like? Thank you.
special announcement. Stephanie Jingle, dancing in the scene, is quitting Queens this year. She's able to compete in a competition, a big competition, held in the summertime sometime.
Thank you.
Yes, Sean. For you, anything.
Thank you.
Jenna, was you here?
No, I like talking to you.
Yes. Did you hear something about Mr. Beakey?
No.
Well, Mr. Beakey, he has the ball. He sees the store and it says, Rose's Laundry. Anything that we clean smells like roast. So he goes, this is great. Takes off his jacket, throws it to the guy, and the guy goes, wishy-washy, put it to your nose, to smell like roast. Mr. Beakey smells it, and he goes, this is great. It's exactly like the sign says. So he takes off his shirt. He gives it to the guy, and the guy goes, wishy-washy, put it to your nose, it should smell like roast. He throws it to him, and he goes, this is great. Another job Hallmark doesn't have to do. So then he takes off his underwear from the screen. And then he gives it to the guy. The guy goes, wishy-washy, put it to your nose. Wishy-washy, put it to your nose. Wishy-washy.
Thank you.
Courtney Kishenka, Bree Donner, Dan Berger, Ashley Wilson, Marissa Jett. And they're going to say, doing what comes naturally.
Thank you. Thank you.
doing this somewhere, she realized it was a poor old man. And she found him and seen it. She noticed the man since she was seeing that street just kept nudging him with his elbow, just like this. And she said, "I beg your pardon, sir." And the man turned to her and said, "I'm sorry, ma'am, but I was wounded in the Vietnam War. And it just caused my elbow to just go like this." So she gave him a dirty look and moved to another seat. This time the man she was sitting next to just kept nudging her with his leg, quite like this. And she turned him once again and said, "I beg your pardon, sir." And this time this man said, "I'm sorry, ma'am, but I was in a horrible car accident last night. This caused my knee to spasm, like this." And once again she gave him a look and moved to another seat. This time the man she was sitting next to kept going like this. "Let me guess, sir. You were injured in some type of accident, and it just causes your arm to move like this." The man turned over and said, "Look, lady, I don't know what you're talking about, but I just picked a booger from my nose, and I'm just trying to..."